the NFL to Hollywood to fatherhood. Join me as I tackle my next journey in life, becoming Hollywood's next action star.
All right, I'm back. It's been a minute, probably about a week. Last week I had four auditions, and some of them were pretty last minute, where it was like a day turnaround. So I've learned, you know, I kind of forgot during the strike, but I've learned just how time intensive the auditions can be and how that's kind of life happening. And it's going to be a lot harder to stay on top of the long form videos every day like I was most days when those times come up, because I didn't go dark on my workouts, but it just felt like another obstacle on top of all the prep that I had to do. Like, I was working out, but listening to my lines over and over again, or reading the script again, listening to it on an, you know, uploading it to an Audible type of app that reads it to you. And I just didn't want to have to also focus on, you know, filming the content, and my mind is so elsewhere. I know I'm not going to deliver a good video that's engaging at all. I just don't have the mental bandwidth for it. I'm too focused, I tunnel visioned out. So that's kind of why I went dark. And hopefully I'll find a more sustainable method to be able to bring these more consistently, even during those times. But for now, I'm back. So let's go get it. Got a warm up in. I'm doing an arm day today. I already got some reverse curls, easy bar reverse curls in, wrist dumbbell wrist rollers, or wrist curls, some calves and neck. And now today I'm going to do some heavier dips with more of like a tricep focus, and preacher curls, dumbbell preacher curls. Then I'm going to go to the V-bar press downs to the incline seated dumbbell curls. And that's going to be finito. That's going to be the whole day. I'm gonna do five sets biceps, five sets triceps, and I know I'm gonna hit them one more time this week, so we're gonna total out to 10 plus sets throughout the whole week, which I think will be good enough with how intense the sets are gonna be. They're gonna be mostly to failure, and I'm really gonna start pushing and tracking the weights a little bit better so I can progressive overload and do the things that build the muscle, baby. Let's do it. I got two blues and a green. That's 245s and 125, that's 115 pounds. I just barely passed algebra back in the day. So I'm gonna take this for a run. Woo! Take it now. I'm gonna do a real superset, which is working the antagonist muscle, my biceps, while I rest on the dips. Left arm's weaker, so I'm gonna go until I can't on that arm and match it on my right. It's a good way to balance out any asymmetries of strength and size. Give it a good couple minutes rest, fully recover, and go up and wait on the dips. 275 felt good. That was for 10. I didn't have any left in the tank, but be good to push it a little heavier. I'll get less than 10 reps, but just want to see how many I can get that for. Start tracking that a little better. So this is literally going to be my last set of the dips and the preacher curls. And that's because it's going to be more of the strength focus, these first exercises, and then the next set of exercises, more kind of the pump, focus. I'll do 3 sets on each of those, and that'll total out to 5 working sets. But because I'm only doing 2 sets here, I'm gonna do a drop set. So I'll take, you know, 3:45s for a ride until I can't, or maybe leave one in the tank, drop it down to 2, hit it again, and maybe drop it again from there. I'm not sure, we'll see how it feels. Way to build strength and kind of blow up the muscle and fatigue it in a, you know, if you have less time and you really want to get a good stimulus without, you know, overtaxing yourself doing a million sets. All right, here we go. All right, right back in with 2. Wow, a lot more fatigue than I realized. I'm gonna drop it down to body weight. I said I did 40 on here, so I'm going up a little bit and going 50. And just a focus that I'm having on these, one, say I'm doing my left arm, I'm putting my hand all the way against this side of the dumbbell. So there's a little space here, and I'm thinking about curling these fingers here this way, really trying to supinate, really trying to hit this short head of the bicep. Drop that right down to 30. Man, okay. Drop it. 30. Here we go. I got 85 pounds loaded up on the V-bar pushdowns today. And that's pretty heavy for me on this rack. Every rack's gonna be a little different. Their plate loading system and how many pulleys it uses. Right over into the seated incline dumbbell curl. This really hits the long head of the bicep, kind of that peak muscle. And usually I'll go 30s with the dumbbells. I'm gonna go 40, just see how it feels. Test out the strength a little bit. I can get one more. Come on, baby. Get it. Eight. Here we go. Right back to the V-bar. Four rep drop off. Should probably give myself a little more rest for the next set. Ooh, come on, man.